All right, here we go. Looking for the green flame. Where are you at? Over in the middle, 3 and 4. Mays is in second place, followed by Jamie Witt, in the number one, in third. And here comes Owens on the inside flanking. Trying to position the ball.
place finisher, driver the number 5, Gary Blanken. Gary, congratulations on a good finish.
Thank you. And we worked hard, Darren. It's bad to get knocked out like that. I don't know, me and Kurt's big buddies, but I swear it's bad to have to try to pass a man and knock the crap out of him like that.
How was the track here tonight at Volunteer Speedway?
Well, it was good. I mean, it's a little rough hole over in 3. It's right where you want to go in the corner, so you need to go under it or above it. But, I mean, other than that, it's a pretty good track. It got a little slick, but you just got to get set up for it.
Had a good strong car tonight. Who would you like to thank?
I'll thank old Frankie Bolden and Chuck and Ron and Johnny. They all work on this thing pretty hard. And I go down there and piddle with them a little bit every now and then. Try to get to them a little bit.
You turn a wrench or two every now and then, huh?
Every now and then they make me.
I wish you congratulations on that third place finish. Y'all give him a big round of applause. Gary Blanken. Coming out from under the hood there. Kurt Owens. Congratulations, Kurt.
Yes. Well, as you can see, it don't look good running up under it there, but that's the way it goes. We had a good race. We just had a little accident over there. And I believe we had something for him anyway.
Who would you like to thank here tonight, Kurt, on this car?
Kip Roden. Guy helps me at Fireball. That's my crew chief. My brother Jimmy Owens too.
Fantastic. Good finish. Second place tonight. Y'all give a big round of applause. Kurt Owens. Winner. Good finish. Driving is number 36, Mr. Chris Rickett. Congratulations.
Thank you.
How was the track here tonight? You seem like you just had this thing from the get-go.
Well, it didn't feel like a get-go when I looked down under me and seen that car on the end there. I thought, uh-oh, I better go. But the racetrack was good. It was a little slick, which probably played into our advantage a little bit tonight because we don't got the motor that everybody thinks we got.
Well, this car seemed to hold real good on that high line. You seemed to kind of stay up in that upper groove all the way around the track.
Well, I didn't see nobody the whole race under me, so I just thought, it's working right there. I'm going to go. And after I seen Kurt nose under me a little bit on the last lap, I sort of pinched down a little bit and tried to block.
Who would you like to thank here tonight, Chris?
Well, Joey, great old big guy over there, my wife, Bill, Alan, everybody for helping me. Without them guys, I couldn't race. And I've raced here, I've been here my whole life helping Red Leffert, helping my dad. And it's the first time I've ever won a race at Volunteer Speedway. This is the one I've been wanting the worst. I've won a race about in every racetrack in Tennessee except here until tonight. So
first win at Volunteer Speedway. Y'all give him a round of applause. Chris Rickett on his first win at the Gap.